Hey, 大家好，我是大林，我是美国的一个 registered nurse， 简称 RN， 也就是注册护士。欢迎各位回到我的频道。那么上两期的视频的话呢，我和大家通过看这个电视剧 Monday Morning 其中的一集来学习了非常多的医学英文。因为前两集的话呢，都是说这个 stroke patient 这个中风的病人在这个送医院和做手术的这个过程。那今天的学习的话呢，我们将不再深入的探讨医学英文，而是转向和美国医疗体系密切相关的一个话题，那就是 advanced directive 预先医疗指示。因为这集的话呢，这个 stroke patient 很不幸的去世了，那这个医生和病人家属之间就有对这个去世的病人的后事进行的一个讨论。美国的 advanced directive 是一个可以帮助你更好的掌控自己医疗决定的强大的工具，无论是你现在身在美国，计划以后前往美国，或者是只是对美国的医疗体系非常感兴趣的话，这个话题都是对你非常的有帮助的。那这个视频的话，也将更加的注重于平时的口语的练习。那我们现在来学习吧。
Sweating could not be contained. Press on other parts of brain.
He's dead.
He's on a ventilator. His body is still working.But I'm afraid he's gone.
Swelling cannot be contained. 就是水肿无法控制。这个 contain 的话用的比较少一点，如果换成是 control 的话，大家应该都懂的。那 contain 这里的话呢，就是控制的意思。Press on another part of brain. 所以说呢，水肿无法控制，压迫到了大脑的其他的部分。啊，然后那个妇人就问 ,He's dead? 他已经死了吗？He's on a ventilator. Ventilator 就是呼吸机的意思。His body is still working. 就是他的器官，他的身体的器官还在运作。But I'm afraid he's gone. 但是呢，恐怕他确实已经去世了。
Sweating could not be contained. Press on other parts of brain.
He's dead.
He's on a ventilator. His body is still working.But I'm afraid he's gone.
Sweating could not be contained. Press on other parts of brain.
He's dead.
He's on a ventilator. His body is still working. But I'm afraid he's gone.
A ventilator? A ventilator? He's on a machine?
Yes.
Well, he didn't want a machine. That's why we filled out all that paperwork, the directive.
A ventilator? He's on a machine. Machine 就是机器。这个 machine 在这里的话呢，就表示这个 ventilator 就是这个呼吸机哈。He didn't want a machine， 啊，他不想用这个呼吸机来维持自己的生命。That's why we filled out all the paperwork, the directive. That's why 就是这就是为什么的意思。We filled out all the paperwork. Filled out paperwork 就表示的是填写这个文书文件的意思。那我们现在来造一个句子哈。The new patient was asked to fill out some medical paperwork before seeing the doctor. 那这句话的意思呢，就是说这个新的病人在见这个医生之前呢，啊，被要求填写所有的医疗的文书。
A ventilator? He's on a machine?
Yes.
Well, he didn't want a machine. That's why we filled out all that paperwork, the directive. A ventilator? He's on a machine?
Yes.
Well, he didn't want a machine. That's why we filled out all that paperwork, the directive.
The advanced directive doesn't actually apply during surgery.
He's really dead.
Okay, hey.
He's gone. How can he be gone?
The advanced directive doesn't actually apply during surgery. 这个 advanced directive 就是预先医疗指示的意思。Apply 是适用的意思。那整句话翻译呢，就是这个预先的医疗指示在手术的期间是不能用的，不适合用的。那这个妇人的话呢，就非常的不敢相信。He's really dead. He's gone.How can he be gone? 他真的死了吗？他怎么能就这样子死去了呢？那大林在这里的话呢，可以简单的提醒两点，就是说明这个 advanced directive 为什么在手术之中是不适用的。那第一个的话呢，就是 emergency situations. There might not be enough time to review or consult the advanced directive. 那就是紧急情况下， 我们也许是没有足够的时间去 review， 就是审查 consult 就是咨询这个预先的医疗指示。下面的这个 consultation 的话就是 consult 的名词形式啊，大家在医院里面工作的话呢经常都会碰到 consultation 的问题。那这里呢我给大家举了个例子，就是 cardiologist consultation。 那第二个原因的话呢，就是因为 anesthesia and consciousness the advanced directed temporary ineffective 麻醉和这个意识不清醒的情况之下呢，这个 advanced directed temporary 就是暂时的失效， ineffective 就是失效的意思。大家还记不记得在片头的时候呢，这个病人是中风了，是完全没有意识了，所以说的话呢这个 advanced directed 就暂时的 temporary ineffective。
The advance directive doesn't actually apply during surgery.
He's really dead.
Okay,
hey. He's gone. How can he be gone?
Hi, Fran Horowitz from Risk Management. We've met before. How are we today?
Busy. Go away.
Of course. This will just take a minute. I understand that you lost a patient yesterday and you're meeting with his wife this morning. Can we talk about that for a second?
下面的这一段话呢跟医疗英文没有太大的关系，但是下面的这几句话的话呢在美语的表达中呢是非常非常常用的，就是我们天天都在用的英文。首先的话呢是这个女人自我介绍， Frank someone from risk management， 就是我是来自于风险管理的 Frank。 We've met before, how are we today？那这句话呢非常适合于就是你之前见过某人，但是呢之后就没有再见过了，今天你又碰到了哈，就想跟他搭话，你就可以用这一句 We have met before, how are we today? 或者是 How are you today? 都可以啊。那这个 Dr. Pa 就说呢我很忙，你现在可以走了。然后呢那个女的又说 Of course, this will just take a minute。那这句话的话呢也是在美语之中经常会用到的，就是说 of course 我知道你很忙，但是呢这个的话只会花一分钟的时间哈，花很短的时间。 I understand that you lost a patient yesterday and you're meeting with his wife this morning. Can we talk about that for a second? 那么这一段话的话大家都理解吗？如果不理解的话请在公屏上面打个一。我现在很快的翻译一下，就是我知道 I understand thatYou lost a patient yesterday. You lost a patient yesterday. 你昨天失去了一个病人。And you were meeting with his wife this morning. 你今天早上要和他的夫人见面。Can we talk about that for a second? 我们来聊一下这个事情。Can we talk about that for a second? 这个短语的话呢，是在美语之中经常会用到的一个句子哈。
Hi.Fran Horowitz from Risk Management. We've met before. How are we today?
Busy. Go away.
Of course. This will just take a minute. I understand that you lost a patient yesterday and you're meeting with his wife this morning. Can we talk about that for a second? Hi. Fran Horowitz from Risk Management. We've met before. How are we today?
Busy. Go away.
Of course. This will just take a minute. I understand that you lost a patient yesterday and you're meeting with his wife this morning. Can we talk about that for a second?
No. Busy.
Well.Understanding that you're busy. I'd nevertheless like to have a conversation, and in fact, Harding Hooten personally asked me to stop by for a chat.
Well, understanding that you are busy. 注意这个 understand, 它放在句子的前面的话呢，一定要是加 ing 的。I'd nevertheless like to have a conversation. 尽管我知道你是很忙的，我还是要跟你谈谈这个事情。Nevertheless, 这个词的话在英语之中是非常非常常见而且非常有用的一个词，表示的就是尽管如此我还是要怎么怎么样的意思。那我们现在来造一个句子， I've already received some information but I'd nevertheless like to have a conversation with a cardiologist。 那这个 cardiologist 在一分钟之前已经讲过是什么意思了，那整句话的话怎么样翻译呢？把你们的翻译的话呢放在留言区里面，我看一下哪个小伙伴的翻译啊最好。And in fact, Harting Hooten personally asked me to stop by for a chat. 这个 stop by 就说的是顺便过来或者是顺便过去的意思。这个词在美语中也是经常使用的。
下面的话我们再来造一个句子。Before you leave the hospital, make sure to stop by the pharmacy to pick up your prescribed medications. 那也是请各位把这个的翻译的话打在留言区哈。
No, busy.
Well, understanding that you're busy, I'd nevertheless like to have a conversation, and in fact, Harding Hooten personally asked me to stop by for a chat.
No, busy.
Well, understanding that you're busy, I'd nevertheless like to have a conversation, and in fact, Harding Hooten personally asked me to stop by for a chat.
Dr. Pa 在职场上非常的不会做人。你们知道刚刚这个女人讲的 Harting Hooten 是谁吗？她就是这个 Dr. Pa 的老板。那这个 Dr. Pa 听到这个女人是他的老板派他来的，所以他才同意了和这个女人谈话哈。他是很会做事，他的手术非常的厉害，但是他完全的不会做人。你说大家都是打工人哈，你痛痛快快的跟这个风险的那个管理人员谈话，那个人就会走掉了。事后你道不道歉还是你的事情，你倒是让他做完他的事情啊，因为他也有他的老板需要交代啊。但是的话呢，美国的医院呢是非常非常的 spoil 他们的 surgeon 的。 spoil 的意思呢就是宠爱宠溺的意思，因为 surgeon 可以帮医院赚到非常非常多的钱。
I know you're familiar with the SORI coalition and the multitude of studies that show from a risk management perspective a doctor's compassion.
Not SORI. SORI did. Not SORI do. Do nothing wrong. Go.
I know you are familiar with the SORI coalition. 这个 familiar with 这个词语的话，大家从初中开始就见过了，就是熟悉的意思哈。SORI coalition 的话就是道歉联盟的意思。我知道呢，你对这个道歉联盟是非常非常的熟悉了。And the multitude of studies that show, multitude 就是很多的 ，multitude of studies 就是很多的啊，学习研究证明。From a risk management perspective, a doctor's compassion. 这个 perspective 就是从什么什么的角度的意思。那整句话的话呢，连起来就是从一个风险管理的人的角度的话呢，这个医生的怜悯之心。那显然的话，这句话是没有讲完的。那我们现在再来造一个句子。From a healthcare provider's perspective, early detection of symptoms is crucial for timely intervention and effective patient care.哇，这句话好长啊！就是从医生的角度来说，及早的发现症状，对于及时的干预和有效的病人护理至关重要。这里的话呢 ，healthcare provider， 很多人会翻译成呢就是医疗的提供者，但是在美国来说呢，他们就是医生。那然后这个 Dr. Pa 就回答的非常的好笑了，他说 ：“Not sorry, sorry that, not sorry do.”Do nothing wrong. Go. 我不会道歉的，我只是对这个病人的去世很抱歉，但是我的手术没有做任何的错事，现在你可以走了。
I know you're familiar with the SORI coalition and the multitude of studies that show from a risk management perspective, a doctor's compassion.
Not SORI. SORI did. Not SORI do. Do nothing wrong. Go.
I know you're familiar with the SORI coalition and the multitude of studies that show from a risk management perspective, a doctor's compassion.
Not SORI. SORI did. Not SORI do. Do nothing wrong. Go.
Yes. Notwithstanding that the procedure was done correctly from a medical and technical standpoint, studies do show that a doctor's contrition.
Not SORI do. SORI did. Not do. Go away.
Notwithstanding the procedure was done correctly,From a medical and technical standpoint, notwithstanding 这个词就是虽然怎么怎么 notwithstanding 这个词就是说虽然的意思 The procedure 指的就是这个手术 was done correctly from a medical and technical standpoint. 那这个 medical 就是医学的 technical 就是技术层面上的那这个 standpoint 的话和刚刚讲的这个 perspective两个都是从什么什么的角度来说的意思，这两个词非常的相像。Study to show that a doctor's contrition，
那这句话挺长的，我们来一起把它翻译一下。虽然从医学和技术的角度来看，这个手术是完全是没有任何错误的。Study do show that a doctor's contrition. 那么研究，就 studies 就是很多的研究，很多的学习的意思。Do show that a doctor's contrition. Contrition 就是同情的意思哈。下面的这两句话 ,not sorry do, sorry that, not do, go away. 这两句话的话大家都懂了，就是
Yes, notwithstanding that the procedure was done correctly from a medical and technical standpoint, studies do show that a doctor's contrition...
Not sorry do, sorry did, not do, go away.
Yes, notwithstanding that the procedure was done correctly from a medical and technical standpoint, studies do show that a doctor's contrition...
Not sorry do, sorry did, not do, go away.
Yes, why don't I just leave you some information to review?This is a pamphlet created by the Sorry Coalition. Doctors find that it too can be very helpful.
那这三句话的话呢，都是比较基础的英文，我就不再一字一字的翻译了。翻译的话直接看下面就可以了。我觉得各位的话呢，应该都懂的这三句英文，都是比较基础的英文。那现在我就有一个问题要问大家，是谁在看我的这个视频？是你们是中国的学医的学生吗？是做医疗的学生吗？是做医疗的人士吗？你们是做什么工作的？还有我讲的这些英文，你们大概都能听得懂多少呢？
Keep in mind that family members' primary motive when having these postmortem conversations is simply ascertaining exactly what happened.
这个句子的话非常的长，我们来断句来看哈。Keep in mind that family members' primary motive when having those post-mortem conversations. Keep in mind 就是记住的意思。Primary motive 就是主要的动机。那 primary 就是主要的。在美国的医疗界的话呢，有一种人叫做 primary care physician。他们就是我们经常说的家庭医生的意思。Post-mortem 的话就是身后事的意思。那我们来把前面的半句话翻译一下啊，记住家庭成员在进行这些身后事的谈话的时候，主要的动机就是，那动机就是简单的查明到底是手术中发生了什么事情的意思。那这个 ascertain 就是查明的意思。
Keep in mind that family members' primary motive when having these postmortem conversations is simply ascertaining exactly what happened. Keep in mind that family members' primary motive when having these postmortem conversations is simply ascertaining exactly what happened. Now, if we were to role play for a second, and I, as Eloise Fernwood, were to ask you, what happened, doctor? Why did my husband die?
Now, if we were to role play for a second, role play 就是角色扮演的意思。And I, as Eloy Fornwood, were to ask you. 大家都知道，如果是用在虚拟语气的时候呢，这个 are 就要变成 were， 就是这个过去式。What happened, doctor? 发生了什么事情 ？Why did my husband die? 我的丈夫怎么就去世了呢 ？Your answer might be. 你应该怎么回答呢？
Now, if we were to role play for a second, and I, as Eloise Fernwood, were to ask you, what happened, doctor? Why did my husband die? Your answer might be?
Fat. Eat too much bad food.
Yes. I'm going to leave you a few more pamphlets. Please, please.